Hi there, Aries. I'm here to get you some tarot messages for today. Let's look into the energies of your person. See what's going on with your person. What do the cards have to say today? We have Hangman, Ace of Sword, Chariot, King of Cups, King of Wands, Knight of Pentacles, Ten of Cups, Wheel of Fortune. All right, so destiny's falling into place here. Ten of Cups, lots of love here. Your person thinks about you. They're heading in your direction here. A new start. They're ready to speak their truth. They know you. You know, you are the key to, you are like the elixir of life, the key to a fresh new start, the truth. Like your person has realized a truth about themselves, about this relationship, about your energy, how it makes them feel, what they want out of life. This connection is blessed. This is like twin soul, twin flame here. Ten of Cups, Wheel of Fortune. You're meant to be. Your person thinks about you. Your person wants to head in your direction. You know, I'm. It's interesting because, you know, Chariot sometimes can be labeled as like the speed or fast movement, but she's like, this Chariot is a snail. So it's like taking their time here. Same with the Knight of Pentacles. It's like taking action. There's movement here, one step at a time. Everything falling into place as it's meant to be. Destiny unfolding. There's no rush here. Like your person's not rushing this. They're allowing things to unfold here. I mean, we have King of Wands, King of Cups. Like, that's an abundance of love and passion. And having it, like, contained. Not contained, like, held back. But having it, what I'm getting is, like, having it sealed, like it's sealed in, like there's a blessing here, there's a knowing, and there's something that's meant to be. It's like a destiny, and you can't avoid destiny, you can't rush destiny, you can't demand destiny. You have to allow destiny one step at a time. And that's what's happening here. I mean, there's an abundance of love and passion and forward movement here, one step at a time. Your person sees it now. They're seeing clearly. They're ready for this new beginning here. Speaking their truth. We have Ace of Sword again. So it's like, yes, taking that sword, stepping up to the plate and saying, this is what I want. This is the direction I'm going. There's a determination, one step at a time. Look at this, Ace of Pentacles. This new beginning is ready to unfold in the real world. Destiny's falling into place here. Seven of Swords. Your person might have felt like they didn't deserve it, or there's something. Seven of Swords, I feel like, is like a, here is a, like a, not thinking clearly here, like feeling that they weren't able to be their true self. You know, Seven of Swords for me, I know it has a lot of keywords, deception. For me, it's about integrity, you know, being true to yourself here, finding your happiness. I feel like your person might have been in a situation that something was expected of them, something they needed to learn, something they needed to experience, something they need to extract themselves from now, because it's not bringing them the happiness they desire. The happiness they desire is with you, King of Cups. The Ten of Cups, they love you, and they're realizing it now. Now it's like, all right, I got to walk away from anything that is not of integrity. Anything that does not feel right in their bones, they're letting it go. They're going to speak their truth. I mean, they may have lived a lie. They may have been on a road that looked good on the outside. You know, okay, as long as it looks good on the outside, everything's good. Everyone thinks we're happy and wonderful and everything's good. But gosh, there's something new that's emerging here. This new beginning, Ace of Swords, Ace of Pentacles. It's more in alignment with truth and integrity and what your person deeply desires. They desire this connection with you. It may not make sense to anyone else, but that's okay. This is about being true to yourself, following your destiny, and not giving two iotas of what anybody else thinks. Four Swords, yeah, it's going deep, healing old wounds, you know, resting after this battle. I feel like, you know, that Seven of Swords might have been a battle, an internal battle, a battle with outside forces, what people think, what people expect. Gosh, this is seeking truth, you know, going in, healing, being true to yourself here. Hangman also, very deep, knowing what they want here. King of Pentacles, they're strong here. There's growth here, Knight of Pentacles, King of Pentacles, knowing what they want, going for it, having what it takes to proceed, speaking truth, having the key to life here on this Ace of Swords. And the moon, it's like coming out into the open here, not letting anything hold them back, not staying in the shadow anymore, moving out of that one step at a time, heading for this love. The love of their life is you. Empress, my goodness, they want to create with you. They're very passionate about you, very emotionally fulfilled when they think of you. They want to be with you. They dream about you like they're fulfilled with you here. Knight of Cups, yeah, more growth here. Knight of Cups, King of Cups, emotional expansion, spiritual expansion, physical support, the universe stepping in with strong guidance and giving the two of you what you both need independently and collectively to support this relationship. If anything is necessary, if there's an element needed, it will be bestowed upon the two of you. There's big blessing here. It's beautiful energy. All right, let us close with our Kuan Yin Oracle message. We have the gates of heaven. All beings have an ultimate spiritual destiny of happiness and freedom. Yet some can become frightened of divine love and believe they will do better to hide from it instead of moving towards it. Sometimes we need to help beings find their way to the light by holding peace and unconditional love in our hearts as we pray for the good that all creatures deserve. Peace be with you. Bye now.